And we're back in the race, and we're currently watching the Vortex car going through the lap traffic. So, quick explanation, the computer on which the stream was running had a failure. It got rebooted, and now we're running running the stream on it again. So guys, what do we have missed?
We seem to have found that after the pit stops, or perhaps during Inex, up to second overall, getting past the Infinity Esports Pro car. Robin Friscott's in the NX car now, and he's pulled out a fair distance from the Infinity car. Vortex still have a very, very healthy lead at the front of the field. 25 seconds over Inex. So far we're running like 60. That 59 of green flag running, we're just past the 90 minute mark. 4.5 hours still to go.
So a quick rundown through positions. We currently have Vortex in the lead. In front of NX Racing and Infinity Esports. Then we've got Genuine Racing in second position currently, with Pit Cannon driving. In front of the other Genuine Racing car, the number 10 with Robin Heimann. So he stayed in the car after the first round of pit stops. Then Tuskinen of Ixion Sim Sports in 6th position. 7th Core Racing Pro 1 with Gunzelmann. 8th Conquest Racing Pro with Kabalowski. 9th Last Lap Motorsports with Jancha. And 10th Hellenic Racing Team, currently the best placed amateur team. From what I see, E-Team has lost quite some ground, significantly.
Indeed, they're right up in about 4th or 5th position overall for comfortably in the lead of the amateur class. But they're down third in class now, 30th overall. But it is in the amateur class, FXR lockout of the podium, which isn't terribly surprising here at South City.
Yeah, what's neither surprising is Hellenic Racing Team again being right at the top of the amateur class. They've had some very good performance during the 24-hour race.
Yeah, it's a very, very impressive win in the amateur class. In the FXR at Kyoto Grand Prix long, which you wouldn't expect. But they're pretty dominant there.
So yeah, in the amateur class, the top three are Hellenic Racing Team from the Flust Motorsports Bus and Savage Sims. No, E-Team, sorry. E-Team who got around Team Virus, it seems. Only in track, it seems. and on the real track, Virus is still ahead of the E-Team, which is more or less a satellite team these days of Virus. Close battle CRM track on LLM Pro and Hellenic Racing Team. We're looking here at Scuderia Gas Racing. Who fell back quite significantly on the last lap. Lost a couple of positions. Behind them, that's the car of Last of Motorsports Bus 2. stops shouldn't be too far away.
Meanwhile, we've got the lead battle in amateur really hotting up now. They're virtually nose to tail coming onto the back straight. It's Hellenic Racing Team against Larsen Motorsports. As Chris Ford would probably say, it's bus wars between these two in the FXRs.
Yeah, maybe that's also the reason why Larsen Motorsports named their amateur teams bus teams in the FXR.
Indeed. Not going to be challenging pink. For the lead quite yet. Not close enough.
Maybe another lap, and then they could be in reach. Move very close through this technical section. Though it seemed like the bus team. Good explanation. The last motorsports team has lost quite a few meters.
And it's also interesting to note that the car immediately in front of this battle on track and for position is the one of the last Motorsports pro cars. It would be interesting to see if that's going to play a role in helping the AM car at all.
In the past, we've seen many situations where the pro car was behind the amateur car. So, a very rare scene, but it looks like the pro car is now falling victim to the Hellenic Racing bus.
Side by side through turn one, but Hellenic gets forced out wide and doesn't get past as yet. Now there's a mistake. We've got LLM looking up the inside into turn three. Gets it down to his contact. They've both lost out from that, but LLM gets through. Very scrappy.
Yeah, and it's Vibus who's taking these positions.
And E-Team as well. Up past Hellenic FXR. Up into second in class.
Vibus who had this very big incident with Genuine Racing just before we had this little technical issue, and they are now taking another position. Should be in 10th now, if I see it correctly.
Right, but LLM coming to the pits quite slowly as well. Very slowly. Came to a halt and stuck it in reverse gear just before the get the entry line at start of the speed limit. No idea what that was about. And now E-Team moved to the lead amateur for the time being.
So E-Team is leading again the class. came pretty close to Virus, but only doing the technical sections. Losing a touch too much on the other parts of the track. Oh, and a car driver renamed himself on the server. That was the 75. Which is Last Limit Sports Bus 2. So they might be in trouble. Currently being in the middle of a battle with Merida, could be. Scooby Agus, I mean. They're trying it around the outside, not through the king. Now breaking to the inside. Many cars there, including the leaders of Vortex. Vortex now has to get through this pack.
Which he does, the LM car pulls over and gives him plenty of space. As he does with Garbanowski in the 11, which is a lap down from the overall leader.
Behind Scooby Agus currently is the team of 6A Thunder. Or how they were called at the beginning of the season, 6 to the power of A Thunder. While the other car in this three-way battle for its 23rd position, just went to mid lane.
We got a puncture for Dig Breeding Program Pro Car, the number 21. Entering the final sector now, coming onto the overpass. Got a left front puncture. His teammate just managed to get by unscathed, but.
Yeah.
Certainly not what the Dig Breeding Program need.
Haven't they had this puncture just an hour ago?
Yes, I believe so. It was a right front that time.
Yeah, that was a right front, now it's a left front. But what are they doing to the tires, honestly?
Could be locking up a lot, could be... I don't know, it could be contact with the wall hurting it. Could be a number of things, just not locking up it, but it's just too... It's not a good sign at all to have two punctures in the first 2 hours like this.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the race, having five or six punctures is not really something improving your results. Turning to track in 19th position. But directly in a fight with Yusila, and Yusila for Last Lap Motorsports Amateurs, the not bus car. So they're in 20th now, and Vortex already behind them again. Last Lap Motorsports not with an ideal move how to let Vortex pass. Stick breeding program right in the bumper. And they have to keep this distance until the overpass.
Oh, they've both made a mistake coming into the final sector. The breeding program types the wall juicer in the LLM car, it's a bit of a wiggle on the rear.
Breaking up these two a bit, but LLM runs wide.
Well, the last time I spoke, number 67 is back in the pits. That was in not too long away from the lead now. Next time.
Yeah, they were just 6 minutes out of the pit lane.
Very odd. Apparently, they had a puncture in the right front, puncture, which is very strange considering they haven't even been on that set of tyres long, presumably. Unless they didn't change tyres.
Yeah, the only thing I can think of is they forgot to change tires. Hellenic Racing is closing up to E-Team, it seems. E-Team currently lapping the Green Angus car. One of those two. Seeing the driver change. Dalda is disconnecting from the server. Now that makes it even more strange, I would say. and from what I am told, it was a miscommunication.
Safety cars, stand by. Safety car boards and flags. Safety car boards and flags.
We've got a safety car out.
We've got a car upside down. It's car racing.
It's number nine
car, which had this awful luck at the start of the race already, where we were pretty happy that it didn't roll. Now it rolled.
And there's a whole heap of new drivers entering the server for pit stops. It's almost bang on 2 hour mark. It's perfect time for a lot of these cars to make their second pit stop of the day.
Yeah, true. Server getting full. So there we see the safety car slowly waiting for the signal by race control to catch the leader.
This is really terrible news for Vortex overall leaders, who had a very healthy lead up front, at least 20-25 seconds last time I looked. That's going to be wiped out completely.
Question will be how many cars are in between the leader and the second place team. So, under caution for the first time today, 4 hours and 1 minute to go, roundabout at least.
Now, Vortex and Infinity pitted, whereas Isaac Price in the Innix racing car hasn't, and it will just about take second place. I guess Innix must have pitted recently. They've got new tyres on anyway.
Yeah, they did two pit stops as well. I think they were just in before the safety car came out. Maybe, and even this is thinkable, they saw the car rolling, directly turned it into the pit lane, thereby pitted one lap earlier than to everyone else.
Indeed, although that almost didn't work for them, because they were getting held up under safety car by the number 75 lap car, I believe. It wasn't allowing them to go as quickly as they would have wanted. They only just held on to second place with the Infinity car, which coming out of the pits at the time.
Yeah, it was a close call.
In fact, they made contact at turn two, right after Infinity came out the pits. Nothing too major. Oh, and Infinity coming in again. This is...
First reports tell us that the core car kind of flipped himself. which doesn't make this incident make less tragic, because they are out of the race now. Retiring just after 2 hours is not really what you want in a 6 hour race.
One car that's benefited a lot from this is the number 10 Genuine Racing. Robin Hydrogen at the wheel at the moment is up to third after Infinity's pit stop. And the next car in the queue in front of him is the next car, which is full position.
Yes, suddenly there is a Genuine Racing car in reach of the podium. It's not that colourful car what one thought it was My Little Pony inspired. Sorry for that one.
And another important thing which I've just noticed is one of the cars that's going to be on the lead lap at the back of the near the back of the train is the number 56 Savage Simsports AM car, and that is the only AM car that's on the lead lap, but it will have virtually a full lap over the next car in its class. It's a huge advantage for it. It's similar to what Hellenic had quite early on in the 24 hour race, which helped it put itself in a very good position to win that race.
Indeed. Very lucky caution for Savage. Very lucky it fell right in this pit stop period. Only two drivers confirmed on the Savage car, so I wonder how many laps Martin Kapal will do.
Well, is there not a rule in the amateur category that the pro driver in the car can only do 33% of the race?
Yeah, true. So he will... Wait a second. That would mean that he would have to be out of the car right now, because...
Indeed. Just...
Now is the question, is Martin Kapal listed as a pro driver? I honestly don't know.
I'll see if I can...
at the end of this lap, by the way.
Get up and find out. Driver, so that's not a problem for him.
So he can. But do.
Safety car in this lap.
So, restart time here. Safety car has pulled away and now we're waiting for Vortex to
gone
on the throttle and they are gone and they look at the lead. They've got a
green flag, green.
Green flag flies and they've got a couple of cars between themselves and the second place.
Car. They've got an awful lot of cars, there must be about 8 cars between them. The safety car may have eradicated their big lead, but they've got a very nice cushion between themselves and the Innex genuine battle.
Yeah, which heats up in the middle of the lap traffic. I wonder how this will work out.
Oh, when Price has been hit in the wall! Into the wall with Price with the back marker. That's that genuine racing in second position. Complete confusion in turn number 2 there. Ah, the safety car restart and Vortex are away again.
NX down in third position.
Oh, we're almost one right one there. That makes on second car, the amateur class car.
Price just about clears the back marker at the hairpin. Then now target is acquired. Robin Hajiman, the next car in front of him on track.
Look at the lead Koskinen, that's right. He's just switched on today. They just seem to be determined to win this race, don't they, Vortex?
Yeah, it's normal service resumed at the front, basically. After one lap, they've got good 5-10 second lead. About 7 seconds after one lap.
Oh, there's going to be contact surely in turn number 2. Somehow there isn't, mostly. There are 9 cars there trying to funnel through. All of the battling for position as well. Position between the virus and sorry, the last one was gone and the ride in the sports car. Absolute carnage at the start as we start
with
the spinner. That is the
Oh, and the savage car on the amateur leader almost gets collected big time in that incident.
Yeah, he got a wiggle on the exit of the corner there. Absolutely frantic restart here at South City. 2 hours into a 6 hour race.
Isner in the core pro car, right behind Dakovic in the exciting sports car for 5th overall. But Isner's not close enough to make that move quite yet. It's going to turn 2. Isner will no doubt have his eye on big pack of cars in front of him. I'm just trying to figure out how he's going to be able to use that to get past that bit.
So of course the genuine racing car has yet to make a pit stop. This position, why is the safety car is that one?
Number 72
has run out of fuel?
Car. It must be the engine's off.
Safety car boards and flags, safety car boards and flags, safety car scramble,
that's
safety car scramble. We have a car stopped at the exit of turn 2. Car stopped at the exit of turn 2.
Okay. Is he going to the toilet?
This is very bizarre, because the engine's off.
Yes, I think this I'm going to go and have a look, Steve. I is he in that position, and why is his engine off and he's in reverse?
So we are back under safety car, second of the day, and second in about 15 minutes. Koskinen still leads for Vortex, with Heisman of Genuine Racing second,
yep.
And Isaac Price third for Inex.
Yeah, he's out of fuel. Well, there's absolutely no doubt about that. He's run out of fuel. Managed to park it in turn two, which I suppose is a sense of place, but this is a retirement from car number 72. Unless they're going to try and push him. Wait, he's in reverse. He needs to not be in reverse. No, he's not there. This is not going to end well if you're going to push this car, because he isn't there. He's not out of his wheel.
He is there. Parking it, basically. I think he's pretty much consigned to the fact that his race is over.
Why are the yellow flags being caused so much? So obviously a miscommunication by that team as to how much fuel they're going to run. Because he's got in here, I think he might be pushed back into the pits. But no chance he's going to get out of there. Absolutely.
Indeed,
no chance.
It's quite tricky to be pushed when you're up against a wall like that.
Oh. Right, I'm going to go and help.
And there's more lag between them, let's see. I can get the
John the Pro ends up on the other side of the car park. This will help Genuine Racing, they can now make a pit stop.
For your information, not understanding what Chris Ford and Steve are talking about. We don't have cameras there, so we cannot really show.
Well, the 72 car is now back onto the track between just before turn 3.
Hopefully everyone gets around. No, there was the breeding program. Chaos. And Savage also with a very late time of notice that
yeah.
Chris, you're not wanting to give us a track explanation with
no.
That car. Too bad.
Martinez has decided that being in reverse gear when being pushed by a rescue car isn't the best of ideas, so he's stuck it back into neutral. They're most of the way around the track now, coming up to the final corner. So he's going to have a bit of saving grace, but he's going to be about 8 laps down off the leader so far.
Gonna go for a quick one, guys.
And this
safety car in this lane.
This strip maker and safety car driver will pull into the pits at the end of this lap. We'll give Koskinen a chance to see if he can build up another big lead.
Now Haley's hoping so.
So it's Vortex again at the restart.
All corners green.
And Martinez coming out of the pit lane right before the leaders.
Stopping on the side of the road.
Been a very poor restart for Isaac Price. He let two backmarkers get in between himself and Robin Eijerman.
There was a little bit of confusion, I thought, there. I thought the safety car message came out again after the green flag was given, or before the green flag was given. Seems this time. The Pirai is having issues with the back markers. In fourth place for Fiji Esports. See, get a bit annoyed. Dakovic is trying his best to make it even more comfortable by getting as close as he possibly can.
And he's going
to come back Dakovic around. Big crash down in turn number two. Dakovic swings around. What are you doing, Nicky Dakovic?
That is ridiculous.
What are you doing?
I'm quite honestly.
Oh, I don't know where to begin. Oh, let's slam it in reverse and try and do a spin turn in the middle of everybody twice.
I don't even think,
you know, a dog with one leg would manage to do something that stupid in that situation. Pure stupidity from Nicky Dakovic.
Nothing needs more to be said about that one. I was saying there's been no carnage. Carnage ensues. By the front, Koskinen does a 30.57. It's a 31.0 for Hydro, and he's still the pit. Under that second pit stop. That's interesting. Well, has anybody got any suspicions as to why that is?
It could be he's trying to build up a gap to avoid this big gaggle of cars in the midfield. And if he pit if you put it down under the safety car, then you would have just had a huge wall of traffic trying to get through with all that carnage, the like of which we've just seen.
Yes, I suppose that is a good point there. With the thinner tyres, they will be able to go consistently quicker, you'd think, despite the XR that they're driving. And they would if they were stuck mid-pack with full tyres and full fuel. Matter for 2nd, 3rd and 4th in amateur class cars, stick breeding program, Hellenic Racing, and core amateur, Ben Keogh driving the core car.
Mr. S in the Hellenic car has the run. Going into turn one, they're side by side with stick breeding program car. And Hellenic make the move and make it stick. Yes, going into turn two, they stay ahead in third place in the amateur category. They're 12 overall at the moment.
Kistner, turn number two. Pace out, so I think he's gained the position there to be fifth now for Tim Byers, head of Core Pro, with Genuine Racing's Knops right up behind him in the not My Little Pony cars. Dominic Inger wishes us all to remember. Nice, really nice skins out there today. As per usual, the Genuine Racing one is actually a class above. That is still a lovely skin.
It does look very nice indeed. And I do like Rabbit Skin, and just the famous black and gold colours.
Yes, it's lovely. Some lovely artwork in Live for Speed still.
And Knox goes around Kistner.
Price is all over Hydrogen. And we don't seem to be working too well for Genuine Racing at the moment. They don't seem to have the pace that you'd expect at this stage with thin tyres. Price is all over the back of Hydrogen. Hydrogen struggling around with the XRR. It looks. Well, they both look out of control, sir. City. That's one of the magnificent things about this track. You very, very, very rarely get a car that looks all neutral and pointy and lovely, but here goes Price around the outside as they break for the final corner.
It's unlikely he's going to get past there, but he's going to try and get the switch back and get the run out of the hairpin.
Indeed. As they come down the main straight back marker ahead of them, he won't pay any part in this attempt. It's an overtake. Hydrogen will stay, you'd fancy, to the left outside. Price is thinking about going down the long way of this first kink. Oh, both of them backed off, and that completely confused each other. Oh. Hydrogen sticks it down the inside again, but Hydrogen's going to be in the pits at the end of this lap by the looks of it. Price hitting the wall, but he's got the plate. Hydrogen sticks his nose in, but don't think he's quite going to get the job done there. And that's a pass for second place. Amusingly, they both backed off and completely confused each other in turn number one there.
Indeed, well, Link could have gone
horrible. We know that Genuine Racing has some history in that corner today.
Do they? What have I missed?
They had this big crash with Virus.
Ah, okay. Nice to see this was protested, of course.
What is it?
Yes, it was, I think okay. That must be the thing you're talking about.
Yeah, probably, because it was a big shunt to the virus car.
Hydrogen pits from third, flies into the pits, is going to get slowed down, Robin, there we go, just slowed down enough, very cold and blue tyres, but he's going to pass over to Dominic Angle for the generating it, a bit hesitant into the pit box there, Hydrogen, but there he goes into the pits. Where is he going to give Dominic Angle that car? Won't be, of course, lower than 10th, I think. Because of course they're 11th and below are a lap down. Kapal into the pits as well. He was the leading amateur class car, I do believe.
Indeed, he had almost a lap as the lead in the amateur class due to the safety car and him not having pitted.
But the front Koskinen cruising away at the moment. It does seem Price seems to be trying his best to cap his lead, but I don't think it's going to happen, and that FXR looking supreme around South City with four supreme Finn drivers of the XR, Samson Ranzo especially, cannot contain his excitement when an FXR is mentioned. He used to mention FXR every single time he'd bring up any kind of discussion about car choices, as we found out in the 24 hour race last year, when he wanted a bus the day before the race, which was interesting. Hydrogen disconnect, Angle is in. I think they've repaired damage because they've dropped quite a fair bit back actually. Kapal's caught considerably. So Genuine Racing taking the decision to repair damage. They are going to try and stretch this stint, no question about that. And they are not out of this, don't worry about that. They are still contenders for a podium today, Genuine Racing fans out there.
Since we've had these technical issues and returned to Simrace.TV, Twitch is actually realizing that this is not our factor, but Live for Speed.
Hooray! People still play our factor.
Sometimes.
Hey then, everybody plays our factor with me.
I remember Oscar and I competed even in a league together. Well, in our factor.
Which one was that?
The V8 Supercar League by TPS.
Yeah, avoid them, they're silly.
Yes. No, maybe. If you want to have a championship with a very strange name, then you have to go there for the Tom Onslow Cole Clio Cup. Because BTCC driver Tom Onslow Cole is a sponsor for that one.
So with 2 hours and 32 minutes gone in this race, Vortex continue to lead for minutes. The gap is stabilizing. Getting the gap up. Oh, well, that's terrific. But it's relatively stable now, but Price has suddenly started to catch Koskinen, mainly in the final sector of the lap with the long back straight where you'd expect the advantage of the XR to come, and it certainly has so far for NX on the last couple of laps. Looks like we're going to get a battle for 6th position between Co-Racing Pro and Ixion Motorsports. Sims Sports.
It looks like this fort is over. This fight is over, I mean. I must say that Pistner's car looks very, very thin at the front part. As if they start to form this thing into a delta wing.
Indeed. He's, put that front right tire is pointing the wrong direction. They have to pit. Sorry, Corey, you have to pit.
So yeah, let's see when he pits. I think Christian is now realizing that he is slower than before this last hit.
Isaac Price suddenly 6/10 of a second faster on the last lap than Koskinen in the Vortex car, so NX making inroads at the moment. I mean, you have to feel for Vortex, they were cruising at the moment, and now they aren't cruising, shall we say, but still a long way to go in this race. They do look the fastest team out there today. Just got to keep it all together, lads. Kistner does pit.
Gardner leaves the pits, but he comes back up in 13th. He's fallen off the lead lap now.
But at least his car is a car again.
You're saying the Delta Wing isn't a car?
No, but the thing, this middle thing between the Delta Wing and the FZR he drove was not really a car. I mean, even the Delta Wing has, in a way, a symmetric order of tires, while what he drove earlier. Yet these the three tires pointing, being in the right position, and then this right front, which was about 10 or 20 centimeters more inwards, more to the center than everything else.
Although the Delta Wing did of course end up with one wheel being in a far worse condition than the others when Kazuki Nakajima barged it off the road at Le Mans last year.
Yeah.
Mostly missed by us. The gap at the front is actually now less than a second, so on a scrappy lap, obviously, someone from Koskinen. He's having some lag issues by the looks of up the hill there. Suddenly his car is not where it was before.
Well, maybe if you watched the first part of this broadcast before the issues, you would say, did he take the wrong route, because back then Vortex was dominant, really unexpectedly dominant. What's with Koskinen slagging?
Oh dear, as I said a second ago, it looked as though he had some kind of lag issue, and he has lagged out of the server.
And thereby, Isaac Price, Inex Racing, leads this race. Speechless here in the country booth. NX leading in front of Infinity Sports and Team Virus, which promotes Virus, of course, onto the podium position. Again, we experienced some technical issues at the end of one of our commentators. To save him, we don't name him. So what else is going on track? Infinity Esports is quite a bit behind. Actually, the reason why Vortex had lost so much in comparison to NX car was engine damage, from the looks of things. Way earlier! Okay. So was it in the NDR IRC, I guess? So yeah, there was engine damage, quite some parts throughout the race, and from what I read, it was about 2 kph that they lost on the start-finish straight, so not too big of a deal. But of course, if that continues, it explains why a gap narrows down. There's a tool called MPRS. I think other tools can do it as well. They read out MPR files. And they can also read out what engine damage you get from shifting down too early. Genuine racing car, which was in second position earlier, They are now in 6th overall. Rundown of positions, we've got NX in first in front of Infinity, Team Virus third. They are the closest opponents for NX for the overall championship. The thing is, next round gives you 1.5 times of the standard pointing scheme, so there's still some decisions open after that, after this round. However, one must admit that the lead of NX Racing is enormous. They currently lead by 46 points, and the most points you can get on a regular weekend, I think, are 52 points. So this shows you how far Team Virus leads. They are actually equal on points with the number 10 Genuine Racing car. So for the finale, you can get 75 points for the win, plus 2 points for the pole position, plus 2 points for the highest climber, though, well, it can't get pole and highest climber in the same score, so it's more that you can at max score 77 points in the next race.
You know, it appears we've had to change third overall. Change of pace in the Virus Pro car has lost out to Nubs in the Genuine car, the ESR.
Yeah, the colourful car is now in front of the blue and black one.
That's the My Little Pony car that's not about ponies. Dominic Engel wants us to stress that.
Yes. Well, currently he can't listen to us because he's in the car, so... Knock on wood, he doesn't hear this. I mean, hear us talking continuously about My Little Pony.
Oh, got Martinez stationary in the middle of the road. Going up after turn one.
He's got a few
facing the wrong way. No, he's back moving again.
He's back moving again.
Yeah. This car's had all sorts of little incidents all through the day. It ran out of fuel, but it's been a nightmare race for them.
And if you look at this car, I mean, you can tell what happened there in this corner. In turn one, and that king, it seems like they took some very, very wrong, strange line, which put them into the wall backwards, from the looks of things. And this is going to be another pit stop for them.
It would be their fifth pit stop of the day. Most damage of a 2 or 3. The next round of pit stops for those who have made 2 will be coming up fairly soon, perhaps in a quarter of an hour or so.
Martinez in the pit lane. Pit stops, Fernandez and Gasly.
Fernandez picked up a drive-through penalty, speeding coming into the pit lane, which is a bad mistake for me.
Yeah, so a very eventful race for them.
Indeed, they're right out battling for the lead in the amateur class earlier, and now they're right at the tail of the field, basically.
Yeah, much bad luck involved in this. Just completed their 100th lap.
Seems Dominic Engel has dropped off the lead lap from Isaac Price, who's come and lapped him. But of course, Isaac will be in the pits relatively soon, whereas Dom has pitted fairly recently. So that will even itself out for now, but it'll be interesting to see how that plays out for the rest of the race.
Yeah, I mean, a lap is a lap. One doesn't get this wrong. The thing though is, they are at very different points of their stints.
Ex- exactly.
And, I mean, just, well, 20 minutes ago, 30 minutes ago, somewhere in that region, we've seen those two cars behind each other racing for position. And we've already had two cautions. That doesn't mean that we get doesn't get another caution.
Indeed, and basically genuine will be hoping for another safety car so that they can break up so terribly that which they surely would, because presumably Isaac or whoever's in the NX car at the time would put the genuine car back on the lead lap. It's potentially still all to play for, but they generally need a bit of help, really, from other events.
So, if you now register any account transmissions from France to Spain, maybe they can affect the end of the race. I think the servers of Genuine Racing in France, if I'm not mistaken. And a certain Spanish guy already caused us some events here. Who you may not count out in a way are Vortex. Since they didn't lose too much during their disconnection. In fact, they're still shown to me as lead lap car.
Indeed, they're in sixth position at the moment, just behind Nikita Dakovic in the race order, just about a second behind, I'm seeing. In fact, it's less than that now, if you on the track. Gervancio's gonna have a look, it seems, going into turn one. Around the outside, still side by side. Dakovic holds onto the inside, but he relinquishes the position.
So that puts Vortex into fifth position.
James Peace has brought the Tim Barry's car into the pits.
Oh, indeed.
That's the pro car. And Robin Friscops has joined the server. So we're expecting the next car into the pits at the end of this lap. From the lead overall.
Then we go with NX. And the 67 failed to surf that penalty in time.
Yeah, you get three laps in which to serve the a drive-through penalty here. If you go past the start finish line, more than twice after being given the drive through, then it gets upgraded to a stop go. That's exactly what's happened to the LLM bus car. Meanwhile, Isaac Price brings the next car in from the lead.
Which puts the Infinity Esports car into a brief lead. Triscup's in for Isaac.
Inwin Racing's FZR comes in, not the My Little Pony car. That's Lops has brought that one in.
Pony car that's not a pony car.
Exactly.
Correcto mundo.
Fernandez has served the stop go penalty in the LLM car, the 67, and he gets back on his way.
It's fair to say he didn't lose that much from that upgrade penalty.
Indeed, it's a long, long way back to start with. He's about half a lap behind the next car, which is the Green Angus Racing car, I believe.
Infinity completing the lap so that they are now that Infinity Esports already served their third pit stop.
No.
They've pitted three times. However, their tyres are looking like they're going to be pitting fairly soon.
Okay, just wondering.
They almost get wiped out by the last time motorboat bus.
Well, fairly interesting. I mean, we've got Infinity Esports with soon four pit stops, followed by NX with three, and Also in the top 10, we've got the genuine racing car, which just had two to this point of time. Some blocking and unblocking of messages going on. Busy. But I think it's fair to say that the racing has calmed down.
In what, our leader in the Infinity Car pits? Robin Friscops comes through in the next car and resumes the lead of this race with 3 hours and 8 minutes to go. 120 laps completed. We're just over halfway.
And we take this moment for a quick break to split up the stream. We'll be back in a few seconds.